Hello. And welcome to the Sunday series, which is unofficially just means I have time to stream on Sundays, and I find I really like it for some reason. So I'm playing a little Valkyria Chronicles, and just to introduce the game a little bit, I'll put it this way. If you're a JRPG fan, and you have been since the PlayStation 2 or 3 days, you probably know about this game already. It's beloved by many people because it came out in the PS3 era, which was not a great time for JRPGs. Things like Final Fantasy were changing dramatically. And then there was, what's the other one? Dragon Quest, which never changes and is just garbage. But this kind of came out of nowhere from Sega, and it turned out to be a really cool strategy RPG, turn-based. So it's really accessible in that way that Japanese games are. I won't get too much into trying to describe the story. This is... Hang on, I'm going to turn my headphones down. I feel like I'm yelling over myself. Okay. So basically, to put it briefly, it's like World War II anime with some, like, supernatural stuff. Obviously, the abilities are pretty, like, arcadey and, you know, surreal, but, like, there's actually surreal stuff in the game. But you basically pick your units, and you set them up for the mission to come, and you know, usually just have to kill all the enemies. Sometimes you have to do something special. If you're looking out for spoilers, this is pretty far into the story, so I would say stop watching the video. But the battle I'm about to play is a skirmish, which is to say that it's a repeat of a battle that I played before. It'll be slightly different, usually a little bit easier, but I'm just kind of doing it to grind some experience out. So, I always bring Alicia, of course. Ted, he's my guy. Rosie. Lately, I'm leaning really heavily into my engineer class, so let's bring a couple of these. Nadine is good. Todd is good. Okay, I think I'm good with that.
Alright, we're set to begin. Good luck.
So as you can see from the character models, the style is very anime, but it's a little more...
Squad seven,
the whole series in general is just a little bit more grounded than your average anime. So if anything, I would say, even though this game is not for everybody, I would say that for a Japanese game and a RPG and a strategy one to boot, this is probably one of the most digestible, widely digestible games to come out of Japan in a long time. It wasn't a huge hit, but it's been enough of a hit that it's gotten sequels. And part of the reason I'm rushing to play through this is because I want to go ahead and finish it and get to part 4, which I bought and is sitting in my hard drive, but just don't want to play it until I beat this one again. Ah, a little sip of beer there. So, I played this game when it came out. I don't know if I had even seen any previews for it. I might have. I don't think I was like super hyped for this game or anything, but I did play it fairly early into release, and pretty much fell in love with it. It's got its flaws, but it's definitely on my good column. And let's see, I beat it, I played it through again, like maybe a couple months after that, and then just kind of forgot about the game. And then this game was re-released on PC, I bought it on Steam, and I was crushed to learn that there was no controller support, because it's not a game that lends itself super well to PC gameplay. To be fair, it's not that great on the controller either. It's got some pretty stiff controls. But I think I would rather play it on the controller, because the PC, like, I think you just end up frustrating yourself with how limited you are. I won't get into, like, the grander story of the game. I'll just kind of jump into it. And, you know, if you're interested, you can definitely hunt this game down. It's very cheap. And I definitely recommend it. But since I decided to play it, I figured I'd talk about the game a little bit.
Leave it to me. Found us an enemy. Found us an enemy.
So yeah, you pick your units, you know, those stars at the top are basically how many tickets you have per turn. Tanks take 2 tickets to move, but they're the only thing, because everything else you got is these individual soldiers. There's 4 different classes, is it 4? 5 different classes. But once you run out of turns, it's the other team's side, the enemy's side. The enemy's turn, rather. So anyway, you gotta be careful how you advance, because you can push a little too far forward and overextend yourself pretty easily. So again, I'm fighting in a skirmish battle, and in a modern game, you'd probably expect the ability to replay a mission to also imply that it's going to be a little bit harder, I would think. I think that's a fair assumption. But this game doesn't really do that, so... And a lot of times these missions in the original state will have had some sort of extra difficulty, like some kind of cannon firing, mortars.
Good.
And if you replay the skirmish, it usually won't feature that anymore.
Leave it to me.
Okay?
Now, what I'm playing is not on the PS3. This is on my PS4. So this is not the original game.
Don't overextend yourself.
This is the remaster, which
enemy unit spotted.
Is not, I don't think, the PC port. Now, this is where I'm speculating because I haven't really done any research into this game. But the PC port felt a lot different than this, so I think that there's some kind of difference.
Been waiting here.
And this port is a lot better.
All units forward.
I shouldn't say that.
Just watch this.
Don't let your guard down.
Okay, and the other thing is that I don't remember how far I got into the PC port, but I'm pretty sure this version has missions that weren't in the original. I'm just going by memory here, but there's been at least 3 missions that I'm like, I don't remember playing that in the original, which I beat twice, so I think I would know.
Damage minimal!
Ooh. That's not good.
Damage minimal.
Done.
I'm so sorry. So
knock him dead. Ooh, found one. Medic!
It's injured. Remember.
And also, each character has individual properties too.
Don't build up on the offense.
Usually, it's pretty cool. Sometimes they're detrimental, but it's not nearly as bad as something like Darkest Dungeon, you know, which is just a troll fest on the part of the developers. This game does have its frustrating points where it's like, you know, you do encounter the odd mission, which basically forces you to grind and level up because, you know, there's no way to beat it, but that doesn't happen too often.
I'll do my best. That won't slow me down.
I did find that the missions that they added to the game kind of threw off that balance for the negative. So I did have to grind more than I think you normally have to in this game. almost gone.
Return fire! I repeat, return fire!
Understood.
Thanks, buddy.
How's their manpower now? Support your advanced units.
Do your nation proud, soldiers.
Oh my God. Such a bastard.
I guarantee this one will slay you. I'll do my best.
Barely see.
Phew.
Good work. Keep it up.
Please advance with caution.
Galleons at 3 o'clock.
Hmph! Enemy unit neutralized.
Take it out, soldiers. Maintain your lines. Undercarriage is blown.
Let's do this thing.
Wait a bit longer and see how they move.
Enemy sighted.
Leave it to me.
Gotcha. I'm not done yet.
Good. That makes things a bit easier.
Your body's yours to use.
What? That's creepy as hell.
Enemy unit sighted. Be careful, soldiers.
Your lines.
Just watch this.
Don't give them time to think.
So, as I've said, I do like this game. It's got its flaws, but I think overall it's a good package. And just personally, it hits a lot of the right chords for me. That being said, the series has gone... I guess I wouldn't say troubled, because it's still hanging in there. They just made a fourth game. But the second and third games were, from what I understand anyway, very different to this. I'm not even sure that both of them were turn-based. So...
Please get back up to me.
I'm not really sure what those games were like, to be honest. I didn't play them. They were not readily available on any platform that I had my hands on. I think they went to, like, mobile consoles or something. Apparently, Valkyria Chronicles 4 is kind of a return to form. Obviously, a different story, and I would expect some upgraded mechanics, but it's supposed to be very much in the vein of this game, as opposed to the sequels. So, I'm eager to see what it's like. I hope that the improvements are positive. Like I said, I did run into a couple of frustrating moments in this playthrough, which has been going on for quite a while, because I got stuck in a couple areas, and I had to just kind of put the game down for a while and come back to it later.
Your body's yours to use.
But I did eventually get over it, so... I'm gonna try not to complain too much and hope that nothing like that happens before I finish the game. I seem to be making pretty steady progress nowadays, so I'm not too worried about it.
We could use some backup.
I'll just say that in the past year, I've created a pretty big... Excuse me. Created a pretty big backlog for myself because I'm buying a bunch of games. I like to think that that's a good problem to have, but... I've been trying in recent months to... actually get through some of them, so... That's what this is about. Clear this game at least once and move on to number 4.
Just watch this!
Please
advance with caution. Just watch this. They're vegetables!
I don't even know what that means. We're gonna have to over here.
Provide the squad some cover fire.
Leave it to me. Enemy sighted. Found us an enemy.
Enemy unit neutralized.
I'm on it.
Put yourself in the enemy's blind spot.
Yes, right away.
Yourself in the enemy's blind spot.
Thank you.
We'll be there in a minute. Hold out till then.
I'll try my best.
Target sighted.
Here we go. Hostile sighted! Hostile sighted! Enemy sighted! Hostile sighted!
Try to keep that front line strong. Please proceed with caution.
Now!
Man down. Everybody be careful. Down. Everybody be careful.
Try to keep that front line strong.
I'll mop the floor with you.
Don't let up on the offense.
Body's yours to use.
Please be careful of stray bullets.
They're behind us!
Let's tip the scales in Galia's favor.
Damn, dog.
Leave it to me.
Where are you? Where'd you go? Watch out for stray bullets.
Way ahead of you.
Understood.
Hurry it up. They won't wait for us. We're sending units out to both sides.
Ted will kill him. Ted always kills him.
Hey, ladies. Nice spot, huh?
I'll fight with you.
I'm impressed, but not surprised.
Cool. This should be... should be just about over now.
Thank you.
Ooh.
Underminer fire!
That was pretty close too, actually. Wow, wow, wow. Uh-oh.
Damage minimal!
Jesus. So lucky now. So yeah, every once in a while the computer decides to actually be tough. Cause see, okay, so it still ate like a bunch of its own turns. It could have easily killed me. This game is not very difficult, and it's you might even say it's a little janky, to be honest. But none of the flaws are really all that bad. You can live with them, usually. I forgive them, maybe you wouldn't, but it's probably okay.
Keep abreast of the situation!
I'm not done yet!
Who are these guys?
Leave it to me.
Coordinates locked. Distance 500 meters.
I've never heard him yell that line before. That's really funny.
You're doing or, well. Just keep it up.
I guess I just didn't notice that. I must have heard it before. Let me help you!
Okay?
Let's take off! Ooh, let me help.
Oh, that's weird. where we're headed.
Think you can push them back? I don't want any wasted lives out there.
All units, take your positions. Tighten up perimeter defenses.
Leave it to me.
Man down. Everybody be careful.
Okay, so after this mission, I have a chapter mission to do, which I also think is new. And then I have, if I beat that first try, there's also the next chapter mission, which is getting close to the end of the game, so almost done with the game.
Set for you, bro.
Well, maybe I can get it after this mission. Oh, cool. Definitely take that. That's probably all I can buy from right now.
Come back again.
Book mode. Here we go. Okay, save that. Alright, now I'm pretty sure I've never played this, and again, I haven't like researched into what changed about this game over the years. This definitely doesn't ring a bell as far as what I remember from the first game. I could be wrong. So I think that at some point new content was added to this game. I'm not sure where it came from, and I could be totally wrong about that, but in any case, I don't remember ever doing this before.
Let me catch you up on the current situation.
Remnants of the Empire's forces spotted center camp behind the region of Barius Badlands. There's gonna split up between the north and south to cut off their escape routes. Then you'll have to weather their counteroffensive as you make your way to the summit. Your objective here is to occupy their base camp. Okay, yeah, this does not seem familiar. Okay, so both tanks are over there. Let's get these guys some help. Wait, what? Leash. Why are they by themselves? Okay. Nadine's, like, kind of bad luck, but kind of good luck, too. Like, she dies on me a lot, but I always seem to bring her back, so there she is. It's gotta be Ted. He's so awesome. Okay, let's go with this, I guess.
You'll commence combat now.
This one's gonna be big. Be careful out there, Sevens. Squad 7, move out!
What kind of weirdos would set up camp at the top of a rocky hill like this?
Well, gravity makes attacks from high places more dangerous.
Maybe that's it. Either way, we should watch out for fire from above. Okay.
Oh, I do remember this one. Actually, yeah.
Enemy unit spotted.
Try to climb up higher.
Enemy unit spotted.
Be sure to watch for return fire.
Here we go.
How many are there now?
Why is that a barely hitting him?
Come in, come in.
Here we go.
Retreat!
shit.
Underminer fire!
Think you can make it up?
Well, I didn't handle the mines too well, but...
Moving out!
I guess I'm alive. Okay, fuck. Don't go down there. Jesus Christ. That was awful.
Sweet dreams.
Man down. Everybody be careful. Come on, boys.
Here I go!
The enemy...
Engineer? Enemy engineer, that's so weird. Huh. Not for this.
Damn.
Just watch this.
Understood.
Who loves you?
Be wary of a possible ambush.
No matter the cost. This is for all of you.
Here, I'll help.
Good. That makes things a bit easier.
Don't get pinned down. Fire back. Attack from both sides.
I'll do my best.
An obvious target here. Be ready for an ambush, soldiers.
Let's do this thing.
That ladder is a shortcut. What's going on up top?
I think I can make it.
Enemy sighted.
Oh, God. Why?
Go down!
Silenced. Head for the next one. All troops, advance.
Let's do this thing. Ain't no stopping me.
On my way.
I feel like an obvious target here. The enemy's defense is tight.
I see an enemy.
Nope.
All units, watch your surroundings.
Entering combat.
Can those ladders provide a shortcut?
Come on, boys, move!
Understood.
Oh, damn it.
Damn.
Oh my God. So, alright, well, that was a short stream, but I don't feel like trying that again. So, see y'all later.